This right here is probably my other favorite record. It's 24. That's what I'm talking about. Dear God, make it all right. Nothing else ever feels right. Just the ability to say, you know what? I at this point in time, right, I like where Kanye is. Through everything that he's had and has gone through, right? The fact that he's found the Lord, who am I to judge and say, hey, when you found him, what's going on, things of that nature. Happy you found him. What the Lord can do for you, right? Because Christ can do some things for us and help change us and shift our mindset and shift our perspective and our thought process and our attitude and our behavior. And so this is probably my favorite one because this feels like the turning point when you feel it differently, when you see it differently, when you understand differently, when the Lord has said to you, nah, we got to shift how we do things. Doesn't make us perfect, doesn't mean you're doing everything right, but I love this because he understands and acknowledging, dear God, make it all right. Nothing else ever feels right. It's only you. And then we speed it up a little bit in this part right here. That part right there. I know you're alive and God's not finished. Going back to that cancel culture that I discussed earlier, so many times people look and say, man, this person made a mistake. I can't rock with them anymore. There's no coming back from it. This finished. And it don't work like that. And so what Kanye just said, hopefully I'm correlating properly to everyone who's seeing this. You know you're alive if God's not finished. I remember I was at church one Sunday and one of the leaders of the church had brought me somebody to counsel, to talk with. And so the guy was talking to me and he's like, man, you know, I killed some people, I murdered some people. I'm not trying to brush over it. I'm just speaking. And he said, man, I killed some people, I murdered some people, been to jail, and God don't love me. God can't love me. Not with what I've done. And I told him, man, Moses led people in the promised land. No, I'm sorry. He didn't lead them to the promised land. He led them to the edge, right? But he took them through the Red Sea, did all these great things for God. He was a murderer. David sent one of his lieutenants or whatever into battle. And while he was in battle, slept with the guy's wife, got her pregnant, and then set up the guy to get him killed when the guy wouldn't come home to sleep with the wife, so that way it could come across as though it was his baby all along. But God said that's a man after his own heart. Now, in neither situation is it about trying to tell somebody, hey man, go out and murder people. I'm not here condoning it. I'm not saying any of that. But I do know that that is not a reason for the Lord to say, I'm going to dismiss you. Man, there's murderers, there's drug dealers, there's rapists, all type of people who the Lord said, I can still work with you and change your life. Not to continue to do what you do, but to change your life. So when he says, you know you're alive and God's not finished. I know people who committed suicide. And I remember T.D. Jakes said this, and I think that's who I heard it from, but said, you're not killing, when you commit suicide, you're not killing your future you, you're killing your past. Or you're killing your future you because all you've known is your past. That's what it is. You're killing your future you. You don't know if a week from you has a different mindset and perspective because you met the right person who shifts your brain thinking, or you encounter God in a way, or whatever ends up happening. And so you're killing a person you haven't met yet over a person you don't like currently. And so when he says, I know you're alive and God's not finished, I hope people really get that, and that sinks in with people that it doesn't matter. As long as God says it's not over, it's not over. And was it Maurette Brown Clark has a record called that? It's not over. Amazing record. Shout out to that. That's a gospel song. Check it out. But yeah, and then at the end with the horns and stuff like that, this is just. The horns, this is gospel. I want to end it with that. Now, again, like I said, it's some other records. I like Remote Control. I like Moon. Again, the record with Griselda and them on it, or I guess Benny isn't on that one, but Conway and Wes, Keep My Spirit Alive. I like that one. I like the record, which one is it? Is it Jesus Lord? Where at the end of it, he has the son of Larry Hoover talking. I really like that one. I really like that one. I like how we threw that in there. That one is pretty good. Where is that? That's at the very end he's talking. I like that one. Tell me if you know someone that needs Jesus Lord. I like that. And at the end, given that, and I feel like that's something that just hearing with the Larry Hoover thing, more so hearing and going back to kind of that Jay-Z line about take all that red cap off, we going home. There's people back in Chicago that you can have influence and be helpful to. Now, I don't know Larry Hoover's situation. I don't know if he's reformed or not. I don't know whether his son is not. But it gives an opportunity to say, you know what? Kim Kardashian was out here doing some good work. I don't care what people say about the TV show and how she got the fame and all that. I don't care about none of that. But she out here trying to get C. Murder out. Out here working to get other people out. Now it does not, I don't know whether people are guilty of what they've done or not, but what is nice is that someone is giving them an opportunity, because everyone who's in jail is not necessarily a bad person, right? And so looking and giving the opportunity for the son to speak, and I thought it was a very good speech. I listened to it a couple times of what he was saying. I'm not gonna play it now, but you guys can, you know, play it, but it's a good project. And so I want to give this, it's a really good one. I did not expect it to be like this, and I really enjoyed it. And so we're going to go ahead and shout this one out. And again, I had a project, I don't rap, right? This was way, way, way back in the day. We could see the album cover, Clean House Music in the background. But when I hear something and I think that it's an 8 out of 10 or higher, and I think this is an 8. This is a solid 8 out of 10. 8 out of 10. What are we listening to? That's what this is. Clean Your House Music. So you guys let me know what you think about the CD. Obviously, these are my thoughts. These are some of the things that stood out to me. What stood out to you? Hopefully you guys enjoyed the album review. We'll be doing the Drake one and also Shang-Chi. And then probably do some talking on the Michael K. Williams unfortunate passing that happened today. Today is Monday. And so, but yeah. So love to your loved ones. It's on everyone on purpose. Have a wonderful, blessed, productive, stress-free day, weekday, weekend, whenever it is that you're listening to this. Till next time.